My name is Patricia Bleckman, and I want to show you how to use the front panel of the KE2 Evaporator Efficiency to set up KE2 Smart Access during a new installation. KE2 Smart Access allows you to remotely monitor and control your walk-in freezers, walk-in coolers, or other refrigeration systems. And it's available when you're using KE2 Evap with firmware 4.0 or newer, or if you're connected through a KE2 LDA. Have the KE2 Evap completely wired. It also needs to be connected to the network router with a Cat5 cable. On the front panel, the controller should now be in introduction mode and prompting you for the room temperature set point. Use the up or down arrow to change the number, then use the left or right to move to the next digit. Once it is set to the desired temperature and you want to save the selection, press and hold enter until prompted to enter the defrost type. This takes about 3 seconds. The default is electric. To confirm this, press and hold enter until the red and amber LEDs stop blinking. Or to change it to air or hot gas, use the up or down arrows to arrive at the selection. Then, to save the selection, press and hold enter until the red and amber LEDs stop blinking. Valve type is now prompted. The default is mechanical. If you are using a mechanical valve, again, save the selection, press and hold enter until the red and amber LEDs stop blinking. If you are using an EEV, use the up or down arrow to scroll through the list. When you find your selection, press and hold enter until the red and amber LEDs stop blinking. The final introduction mode prompt pertains to smart access. By default, KE2 Smart Access is disabled. Use the up or down arrow to change this to enabled. Then, to save the change, press and hold enter until the red and amber LEDs stop blinking. So, we are finished working with the controller and ready to pull up the dashboard. Using your PC, phone, or tablet, enter smartaccess.ketotherm.net in your web browser's address bar. Once you reach the login page, enter the default information. The default site information is installer, and the password is the controller's MAC address found on the back of the controller. Enter it and click login. And there you are on your own KE2 Smart Access portal. As you set up additional controllers on the portal, you will see them join the dashboard. From the dashboard, you can take an in-depth look at any individual controller by simply clicking on that controller, and that accesses the controller's web pages. Another thing I should mention is that you can set up alarm notifications on the dashboard, so all of the controllers on a portal can alert you via text or email of a system alarm. And if you're interested in customizing the dashboard, see our video 66. For more information, visit our website or contact our technical support line, and we'll be glad to help.